when I start teaching engineering, I like to start with just a really quick little anecdotal example.
And where did you find these projects?
This one is actually from the Museum of Science in Boston.
Oh, great.
Called Engineering is Elementary. It's really inexpensive to implement, but really engaging and interactive. So when you look at this, does it look fairly strong to you and stable?
No, it's not very stable.
And so when I show this to my students, I usually ask them to think about it like a school. Say, well, okay, if you're playing outside on the playground, what happens if a kid kicked a soccer ball, because this happens every day, and it lands on the roof? Right? That adds a little bit more pressure, right? And then what happens is the adult has to go up and try to get the soccer ball off, and every time they step on it, it pushes down a little more. If this was our school, does this seem very strong, very safe anymore?
I'm actually impressed it held 4 pennies, but no, now you're virtually on the point where it's going to bow out.
So what we want to do is think of a way to solve this problem. Could we make this structure more strong and stable just with these supplies we have?
If we made another pillar, we could fold that up and put a pillar in this in the middle there. Yeah,
so
I think this is going to work a lot better. That'll be
do.
Interesting to see.
Okay, so back to the example. Soccer ball comes along, bounces on the roof. What do you notice just then?
This is looking pretty good, actually.
All right, so how many pennies did the last one hold?
7.
7. So let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. What do you notice now?
Because of that pillar in the middle, there's not hardly any buoying at all.
Yeah. All right, so let's see. This is 7, 8, 9, 10. And then we'll add some more and see how far we can go. 25, 50, 55, and I'm out of money.
Wow.
So is this structure stronger and more stable than the last one?
Dramatically.
Dramatically.
I'd rather be at this school.